Welcome, final expense agents and brokers, to the most popular audio training and podcast in the industry, The Lead Jerk Show, where we cut through the red tape and give you only the best in expert interviews. So strap in and grab a cold beverage and get ready to learn and earn. Now, it's my pleasure to introduce you to the one and only Matt Lowery, also known as The Lead Jerk.
Alrighty guys, today got a really good interview with Jeff Root. He is the author of The Digital Life Insurance Agent, How to Market Life Insurance Online and Sell Over the Phone. So there's a lot of good tips and tricks in this interview, and there'll also be a link, depending on where you're listening to this, there'll be a link under the video where you can go and purchase the book, and I highly suggest it. It's I've got one in my hands. I'm about halfway through reading it, and it's really, really good, chock full of good information. So he did not hold back. So, alrighty, on with the interview. Thanks, guys. And remember, for the best final expense leads in the country, visit www.theleadjerk.com. Again, www.theleadjerk.com. Thanks.
All right, everybody, I'm here with Jeff Root. And Jeff is the author of The Digital Life Insurance Agent, How to Market Life Insurance Online and Sell Over the Phone. Jeff, I'll hand it over to you in just a second. I'm not real sure how long the book's been out. I do have one in my hands now. To be honest, I'm about halfway through reading it just with, you know, so many projects going on. But I wanted to just initially kind of ask you about how, you know, your, a little bit about your background, how you got into insurance, and, you know, how the book came to be.
Sure. Absolutely. So, yeah, I guess I'll start where I started in insurance. I started at Northwestern Mutual, you know, doing the financial planner route, got my Series 7, 66, made it about a year there, and I started to buy some leads, and I sold a couple of those leads over the phone, and I thought to myself, why am I seeing people, and, you know, I'm this fresh-faced kid out of college, and, you know, I'm having a hard time getting anything that's over $500 in premium to sell,
right.
And I'm selling these bigger policies over the phone, just the first couple ones I had. And I started, you know, I made that my focus from there on out. I left Northwestern Mutual. You know, I wasn't making much money on the investment side and things. And it was, you know, life insurance was really, really lucrative. And so I started focusing on that. Fast forward a couple years later, I joined a life insurance call center. And at that call center was where I was selling anywhere from, you know, 5 to 10 policies. These are no exam term life insurance policies a day. My best day being, I sold 12 policies in one day. And I realized that my income was based off of the marketing department of the call center. Whenever they did a big email drop or a radio ad or whatever, you know, that's when our phone would light up. That's when leads would come in. And that's where we had our best weeks, our best days. And, you know, it was there I just became a sponge to the marketing department. I wanted to sit in on all their meetings. I wanted to, you know, kind of spy on everything that they're doing. And, you know, it was at that point where I realized, look, it's, you know, it's about having people to talk to. And if you can control that, then you have full control, full freedom in your business. And, you know, that's what got me to marketing online myself. So while I was at that call center, I taught myself how to market online. So fast forward outside of the call center, and, you know, I started blogging for leads. A year later, I was getting daily leads. You know, I learned some other marketing techniques, and, you know, a couple years later, I wasn't selling anymore. I had a team selling for me, and it's just been growing since then. And that's kind of where I am today, is now I'm, you know, getting a lot of agents contacting me. Started selltermlife.com, I think 3 years ago. Due to the fact agents were contacting, like, hey, how are you getting in the top of Google like this? You know, how do you actually make money selling over the phone? You know?
Right.
And, you know, I started a blog, and that blog turned into a podcast. because I really don't like writing anymore. So
right.
I thought podcasting would be better, and it was. And that podcast then turned into a book out of all the questions I was getting. And so to kind of circle back to your first question about, you know, how did the book kind of come about, is I'm just getting a ton of questions. I'm spending, you know, hours a day on the phone with agents repeating the same things. And now I'm
right.
I just got to put this in a book, you know, and just get it out there. And not just, you know, the process or, you know, what it takes, but everything I know, just put it in that book. And I know that this will, you know, help a ton of agents who actually put it in process and
right.
Answer everybody's questions. So I can now save a couple hours out of my day now that I have this book too.
Sure.
And provide a ton of value. So yeah, that's where I got to the book today. And so far we're getting, you know, really good reviews. I know agents are, you know, it's kind of opening up a lot of agents' eyes to kind of the internet side of the business, selling over the phone. You know, we got all the scripts in there, kind of a roadmap to start building your online presence, to start getting, you know, inbound leads and making your phone ring. So, yeah, that's where I am today.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I, and as far as the, you know, the internet marketing goes with really anything, I mean, we could go really deep on that, but for the purpose of the call, obviously, we don't want to go too deep on that because there's a lot of really good content in your book about how to do that and how to, you know, set yourself up to market online. And, you know, what I always find funny is it's really smart to put it in the book format because you could, and you can let me know your feelings or experience on this. You could put all this on your blog and very well majority of it could be. And what I find interesting is a lot of people won't necessarily read, you know, 100 pages, 200 pages of content on the site if it's just pure content, right? But they will hold the book and read it. So
Exactly.
You know, yeah. I don't know why that is. We put all this work in.
Yeah, well it's also because, yeah, if you have, you know, different blogs or podcasts, it's all, you know, it's all compartmentalized. I mean, you have a blog over here about this and about that, but I just, you know,
right.
If you put it all into one cohesive book where it's all streamlined and there's,
yep.
you know, kind of a path to reading the content, it makes a lot more sense rather than hopping from podcast to podcast or blog post
right.
to blog post. So, you know, and actually
not have internet either. Yeah.
Right. So, you know, to have it kind of in your hand to reference, flip back and forth where you don't have to, you know, click the back button a few times and find different things.
Right.
Yeah, I thought it
right.
would be a much better tool than to, you know, a couple people told me, Jeff, create an online course where people can pay, you know, a couple $100 to learn all this. I'm like, no. I'm
right.
just going to get the information
right.
out there. You know, it's $15.95 on Amazon, and you have everything that you need to know. Now it's just up to you to take action, you know. It either
exactly.
suits you or it doesn't. So.
Exactly. Well, that's cool. I guess that was your, you know, quote-unquote root cause for
yeah.
put it out there. You know, and looking over some of the stuff in there, I can appreciate how you kind of, it seems like you kind of zeroed in for agents where, you know, I'm a big believer in only talking to people who raise their hand, right? Now, they may raise it multiple
yep.
times over a sales cycle. However, if you're still engaged with them, that's what makes things work, and that's kind of been my forte, you know, over the last 20-plus years on in anything that I've sold or marketed. Was that one of the things that you noticed, like kind of getting into this and, you know, once you kind of, you know, figured out, hey, there's something to this and I just need to, you know, grind off the rough edges and streamline it. Is that something you notice is not talking to everybody that comes through as a lead? So, you know, and learn how to put your content out there to attract the people you want to actually do business with.
Yeah. I mean, the key to all this is just having people to speak with consistently. When it comes down to everything, you just need a consistent flow of people to talk to. And how you do that, it could be different for everyone. For me, it was this online route, making my phone ring from creating content in search engine optimization. So, you know, instead of out there, a lot of agents will go out there and prospect and buy leads and everything. You know, for me, it's about optimizing my website. It's about writing a new blog post. And when I write a new blog post, it's really delivering content, delivering information that builds trust with the visitor to the website. And right. they feel confident to fill out a form on your website or call you because you're giving them the information on their own time. I think that's key, is that delivering information on people's own time. They're actually out there searching for this, you know, and if you're in front of them while they're searching for this information, you're working on their time, you know, rather than, you know, us, you know, I don't know, cold calling or door knocking, interrupting their days. You know, they're actually right. in the process right now. So, yeah. I mean, I don't want to focus my time and efforts on people who, you know, aren't necessarily in the market today.
Right,
I'd rather focus
right.
on the people who are in the market today. And that's kind of the whole, you know, mindset shift of marketing online, too, that you really don't even think about, is that you're talking to people who are going out there and looking for this. So it's not like you're sending them a piece of mail. And I know direct mail works for final expense and, you know, and direct response and everything, but it's just another way of going about it. But it does take time to develop and to learn. And so though, you know, the first 6-12 months you're learning about this, it's a little frustrating. You're not generating much leads, you know, agents need to have some sort of income during that time while sure. they develop this. But at the same time, you control everything. So, you know, if I don't know how it is in final expense, but, you know, direct mail costs, if they go up or your, you know, the response percentages go down, you know, that stuff kind of out of your control. But if you can kind of control yeah. your marketing machine, that's a lot of stability. You're building a sellable asset. You know, it's a little bit more freedom in the business to know that your phone is, you know, you're going to wake up to leads in the morning, new leads, new people who are going to call you throughout the day. Building yep. that up, it takes a little bit of time, but that's kind of the mindset shift of going through this kind of process of marketing online. Because once you build a marketing funnel that spits out consistent profits for you, I mean, you just need to hit it once. I mean, I know agents that do this in many different ways, not just SEO, but referrals, paid marketing,
right,
so on, telemarketing. I mean, there's lots of different ways to do this. So, but yeah, that's kind of the process and kind of the thought process behind marketing online. And, you know, it's just getting, the book discusses this, but the pool of prospects are just getting bigger who are searching online. I mean, I'm kind of long-winded here, but.
Final, go ahead.
Yeah, I know that final expense is being sold primarily in the field, right? So,
yes.
And I get it. Yeah, I get it. Baby boomers over the age of 65 were just too young to fully experience, you know, the technology that we're seeing today, and they aren't comfortable transacting business online or over the phone. You know, technology hasn't played a big role in their life. But in the future,
right.
selling over the phone or through some sort of electronic process, you know, through your website, or at least generating interest through your website, at some point in the future when those, you know, as more people who are used to using technology, you know, get into those upper ages in the final expense
right.
sweet spot, you know, it's going to overtake it at some point. And, I mean, probably not for a while, but, and I know I'll get a lot of pushback from a lot of agents right now that are listening to this, like, no, that's not going to happen.
What?
But,
yeah.
Yeah, but it's just what we're seeing. We're selling a lot of final expense over the phone in our agency. We are. And,
right.
You know, it's just as more of the younger boomer generation who are used to using technology start becoming a bigger part of the final expense marketplace, you know, I think direct mail and other direct response ways of generating leads will become harder to turn a profit. And that's probably, you know, at least 5 to 10 years away, but it, you know, eventually I think that's going to happen, and it's going to, you know, if you're able to control your marketing and, you know, and figure out over the next few years how to start generating leads for yourself online, that's going to be, you know, it's going to be huge for any life insurance agent.
Well, yeah, and saying that too, by that time, I mean, your CPA or, you know, cost per acquisition or customer, I would think probably it's going to be way less online than it will be for a direct mail lead. You know,
yeah.
Guys have to think about that. I mean, right now you're looking to get a decent direct mail piece in final expense the way that it needs to be with the correct filters. you know, age groups and income, stuff like that, you know, it's probably $30+ per lead. And that's if you're lucky enough to be on a fixed fee program, right? Okay. So if you're dropping yourself, it can go all over the map. And the thing about what I think, like, people like you are doing and have discovered and what other guys need to listen to and start to kind of try to latch on to is that at some point, you know, people will make the argument, well, but I'm getting all these filters on here. Well, what the websites do for you, if you, like you said, if you build them out correctly and have your sales funnels connected properly and make it seamless, they're going to filter out that for you already anyway. Mm-hmm. Because typically, what I experience, I have a couple of different sales funnels and stuff that I do. And like you said, it is nice to get leads every day. I've got leads come in every single day. And, you know, the content you put out there is purposely put out there to filter away certain people and to bring in certain people. And I think that sometimes, you know, people, us face-to-face guys, forget that there is a way to do it online that actually can, you know, filter out income and can filter out, you know, different geographical areas. It's just, you have the option once you get a lead, if you have enough, you know, you're gaining enough knowledge off of what you're asking in an opt-in form or whatever, you can make the choice whether you want to contact them or not.
Absolutely, yeah.
You know?
Yeah, there's, so, you know, a lot of agents, I mean, I've talked to some final expense agents out there who have tried internet leads and it doesn't work. But there's a difference between buying internet leads from a lead vendor who's will sell you any source of traffic from anywhere on the internet to generating your own leads where you control the, you know, they trusted your content or they went to your site and you're actually calling from that website, you know, that they fill out the form on, that, you know, kind of that congruency of everything. And, you know, you're the one actually calling them. That's completely different. When you're generating your own lead, there's already a built-in trust there. When you're buying an internet lead, that's not there. So I think it's completely different. A lot of, you know, I've spoken with final expense agents. Oh, no, internet leads don't work. I'm like, yeah, because you got to generate them yourself for them to really work. That's where the power of it all comes in.
Not only that, how many times are being sold? I mean, I only, we don't do that, but I know for a fact a lot of the bigger companies, and I'm not saying anything nobody doesn't know, well, if they don't, they're going to know now. A lot of these companies that generate leads online, they sell them at least a minimum of 3 times. I mean, if they're not and you're buying exclusive leads, then it's, you know, it's expensive. So that's just a fact. They're looking to turn a profit too.
Yeah, I talk to internet-based life insurance agents every day, and I don't know a single agent turning a profit on buying internet leads from lead vendors. You know, so I don't. I mean, it could be profitable for 3-6 months maybe, but if you have a bad month, if that lead vendor, you know, takes on a traffic source that's just crap, you know, then that affects you. So, you know, I've never met somebody in the business working internet leads for, I'd say, more than a year successfully. You have to, if you're going to do the internet base, you have to generate them yourself. And, you know, the barrier to entry keeps coming down with all the information out there. I mean, you just got to implement. You just got to shift your way of prospecting. Instead of prospecting how you're currently doing it, you're prospecting online. It's just, you know, we all learned to sell insurance. We all, you know, didn't know anything about life insurance. Then we all took a class and we all got licensed. You know, it's kind of the same thing.
Right. So, for those that want to digest the content, it's there. I mean, it's right here in your book. You know, basics you can learn pretty much anywhere. I think you can either, you know, some people might say, hey, if you know how to cut on a computer and you're on the internet, you can do it. You got to educate yourself. You got to read some books. You know, you got to network. You got to talk to some people that know. I've always been the kind of business guy that I want to talk to people that know more about the subject matter than I do, so I can learn something, right? And there's very few people out there, and it's funny that you say that about the lead vendors. there's maybe one that I know of that consistently generates like stock expense leads online. But the problem is, and agents try business on it. The problem is they're really expensive. I mean, you know, when you look at you know, internet lead for final expense maybe being in the $40 range. If you play your cards right and do what you say in this book, you could probably generate that yourself for, you know, less than a buck or two. I don't know the max on exactly as far as you know, end user lead generation, but I know from what I do on the other end, it's way lower than what you know, some of these companies are selling their leads or reselling them or resharing them or whatever they've got going on in there.
Yeah, so there's a final expense lead company out there that was selling Facebook-generated final expense leads, and agents thought they were great, you know, and so I'm like, all right, I got to test this out. I know how to use Facebook ads, and I did, and I was, you know, I didn't optimize it, but my first campaign I was generating leads for $20 to $25 a piece, you know, in that range, and I'm sure if I optimized it more, I could get it down a little bit. So,
oh, yeah.
I mean, an agent can learn, just take a Facebook ads course, you know, and start generating their own leads online if they wanted to. I mean, it would probably take you a couple weeks to get up and running on Facebook once you, you know, digest all the knowledge, implement it, and then just start testing it, and you can build out your own funnel. So,
yeah, it's really cool you mentioned that. I mean, you can geo target all that, you know.
Exactly. You can geo target on Facebook. You can, you know, set the ages. So I guess 50 plus or 60 plus if you wanted to. You can set the income levels. So, you know, to actually get people in the market for final expense, I'm not sure with your demographics, but I mean, all that stuff you can set on who sees these ads. And as long as you have a compelling ad, compelling image, and a, you know, kind of a high converting landing page, you know, optimize those things and you're, you know, you're in business.
Hey, Jeff, that brings us to another question I have for you as far as, and obviously, you know, we don't want to go into a huge amount of detail on a lot of this because we, you know, I want people to get the book and read it and learn on their own. But as far as, when you have somebody that raises their hands, hey, I'm interested, I'm a lead, do you put them in any kind of funnel? Or, you know, do you have anything, you know, that you normally do to stay in touch with them if they're not buying right away or anything like that? Because, I don't know, I guess it could go either way. I don't know exactly how, you know, life insurance kind of those things where people buy it X amount of number of times statistically in their life, which is actually really funny if you think about it. But, is there any? Do you put anybody? You put people in funnels that come in as a consumer lead, you know, and say, "Hey,
yeah,
I want to talk to you."
Yeah. So I discussed this in the book too, but we used, you know, they go directly into our CRM. All leads post into our CRM, and we use something called queue-based calling. So basically, what that means is our CRM displays the next best lead to call. So new lead comes in, it pops up in our CRM. You know, you dial that lead. We have click to call. You just click on it, and it starts calling it. You disposition that lead. If you didn't get a hold of it, you know, you just put no contact, click that button, and then it displays the next best lead. That might have been from 3 hours ago. It might have been from yesterday. It might have been, you know, from a few days ago. So we have it set up in our CRM that every single lead gets called at least 12 times over 45 days. So the bulk of the calling is the first week. Then we space out the calls, and we make sure we hit them, in, you know, for 45 days until they, you know, until they're out of our calling sequence and they go to an email sequence. So, you know, along those calls, they're getting a text immediately from us. As soon as you fill out a form on our websites, you're going to get a text and an email saying we're trying to get a hold of you. When's the best time to reach you? So all that is automated. People respond to text, by the way, more than
they do. It is funny. It's funny. Yeah, they do.
Yeah. So, So we have, you know, we call it our sales machine, but really it's a funnel that every lead goes through. They're all getting the same amount of calls over the same amount of days. Once you contact them, you quote them, or they say call back a different time, we pull them out of our attempting contact funnel, and now we set follow-up dates. And so our CRM will display that lead, you know, when on the date that you, date and time that you say that they wanted a call back or follow up or whatnot. So basically we're letting our technology run our day. And we know at the end of our day is done. Once we get to the end of that call queue and it says no more leads to be called, we know we're on top of all of our leads. We don't have to decide who to call next or anything. We just keep clicking through and dispositioning leads. That's, you know, that's kind of our sales process. I discuss it in the book, but that's our sales funnel.
So, I think that's huge. I mean, that cuts down on so much clutter and, I've seen where people try to run a business and not have that in place, and it's tough. Your time gets sucked away, and we were just talking earlier before we started the call about how, you know, time starts moving fast. You know, when you get busy, life starts happening, things start moving fast, so you've got to have ways to streamline and make things a lot more effective, especially once you've gone through all the work, right? Because you build the infrastructure up front, and now it's working for you, so you better have a way to make it the most streamlined on the back end, or you could actually lose opportunities. Go ahead.
No, I was going to say I think one of the benefits of creating these processes is just freeing up that mental white space so you can think about building your business. You know, you don't have to think about who to call next or worry about if some lead is getting called or not. It's just very satisfying knowing all your leads are getting called the way they should be, and there's nothing else you can really do, you know, to get in contact with them. So that mental white space is huge. You're freeing up. You don't feel as cluttered. You don't have all these leads sitting around at your desk or, you know, in your email.
Right.
So, you know, and you don't have to feel bad about not calling leads. You know everything is getting taken care of. So you can work on lowering the cost per lead, you know, better conversions, learning some new products or marketing techniques. I think that's the key to it.
Yeah, and I know that from looking through here, when you actually start breaking down, too, on, you know, some of that front-end stuff as far as, you know, optimizing your site, making sure it has domain authority, which some of these terms may be foreign or alien to some people listening, but that's what the book's for, to give you guys listening a little bit of knowledge and some education on what some of this stuff means, because it's very important to have that. And let me ask you this, and this is something everybody can appreciate and probably understand a little bit about if they're on the internet at all. Have you seen anything or had to deal with any of the Google algorithms changing, you know, stuff like that? And how do you usually approach that? Because, you know, they're always, you know, people say that Google's your friend, and yeah, some days they are, but some days they're not.
Yeah, I mean, in the past, I was hit pretty hard by some Google algorithm changes on some of my sites, you know, but
yeah.
I learned from that. Not going to hide from that. I had one site that was generating 750 leads a month. We did something really stupid to that site, and overnight, I remember that gut punch. I looked at our lead and it went, yeah, and it just went down. We got a couple leads that day. And, we were doing some risky things. So,
yeah.
You know, I've kind of pulled away from that, and, you know, I'm constantly up to date. And it's easy to be up to date on SEO stuff. There's a ton of content out there, a lot of authority domains, authority websites talking about SEO. Just subscribe to their email list and, you know, kind of get on top of everything. But, yeah, so we do everything – you know, the way it's supposed to be done. Great content.
Yeah, white hat.
Build your domain
white
authority, and it'll come. You're not going to get the results quick as if you did kind of the riskier stuff, but
yeah,
your site's not going to last as long either. So,
yeah.
You know, one of the things I do on webinars is I show people, look, this is a shot of my analytics from, you know, 2011 of this website to today. You know, and consistently this website took me a year to get there to get daily leads, but it's constantly gone up. This website, this one website generates, you know, 20 plus leads a day for me And it has for the past few years, you know? And yeah, it took me a year to get there. The first year, I wasn't doing much at all, you know? But once you get up there and once you build on that, that's really powerful. That is, you know, that is a huge income stream for any agent if they can just commit to it. And I outline that in the book as well. But
yeah. But it takes a while to build content, you know, if it's original.
Right.
You know? It takes a while
right.
to do it.
Yeah, and, you know, we're life insurance agents. We're not writers. This isn't fun stuff.
Right.
It's mind-numbing work. So
it is. And,
yeah,
like,
but it's just
it's work to get it out.
Exactly. It's just nobody likes to door knock either. It's just something you have to do. So
now, with do you? And I know you go over, you know, landing page distribution and stuff like that, and obviously the article and content marketing. But do you when it comes to, you know, agents, you know, trying to generate leads online, do you recommend they try to send, you know, just paid traffic if they're trying that out, PPC to a landing page, and organic traffic directly to their site, you know, for organic, you know, results?
So for organic results, organic means, you know, they get to your site through the search engines. You know, they're typically going to go to your blog, to one of your blog posts. And so, you know, and I talk about this in the book is how to get more conversions out of there. Because you can have 100 visits to your website and get one lead if you have a horribly converting website, or you can get 100 visits to your website and get 5 to 6 leads, you know, triple that amount,
right,
just by the design of your webpage. So that's something, you know, agents can immediately take away from just by following, you know, if they're getting organic traffic. As far as paid traffic goes, you want to send them to a landing page which doesn't have a lot of content, maybe 2 or 3 sentences about what they're going to get, you know, bait them with, you know, instant quotes or whatever you want to bait them with to get their contact information. And, yeah, you only send paid traffic to those. And speak, you know, while I'm on the subject of paid traffic, you know, I wouldn't suggest an agent go, you know, start running Facebook ads to a landing page or, you know,
right,
Google AdWords or whatever. You know, learn about it first. Take a course.
Yep.
You know, you're going to save yourself a lot of money by paying for the education first. A lot of agents say, oh, Google AdWords doesn't work. Facebook doesn't work. It didn't work for you because, you didn't know much about it. It's not as simple as just funding a, you know, an ad spend. There's a lot of optimization involved to get a campaign working.
Yeah, there is. And you can go broke if you do it wrong. Especially if you tick off the wrong button when you're setting up your PPC campaign, people need to watch that. So let me ask you this as far as, you know, like, I know it's a lot of generalization stuff, not necessarily about life insurance, but you were talking about, you know, the industry, but, yeah, kind of important for guys, and I know you go over this in the book as well, and guys, if you're listening, you need to get the book. It's awesome. It's a lot of information, and it's broken down very easily to read. If I can understand, anybody can. Okay. So WordPress, or is that where you think is going to be the dominating force as far as websites, WordPress? With saying that, I'm not real hunky on the free sites. You know, WordPress obviously has 2 different programs. You know, I just don't think that the free ones, I don't know, from what I can tell, they don't have as much optimization opportunities as, you know, a paid type of website. What are your thoughts on that, Jeff?
Yeah, well, first of all, yeah, WordPress is what we build all of our websites on. It's easy to use, mm-hmm. Easy to optimize. Anyone can do it if you don't need to know code or anything like that. And then as far as which WordPress to use, there's two kinds. There's one that's hosted by WordPress, and then there's one that you host yourself and that you customize yourself. So always do the ones where you customize yourself and you host yourself. You have complete ownership of it. And yeah, that's what we do for all of our sites. We host on WordPress.
Yeah. Plus you can. There's a lot more customization you can do with plugins and little gadgets. And guys, for if you're listening, you don't know what that is, that's basically just different programs that are custom built already by developers that you can just, you know, slip into WordPress to do some kind of function for you. That's all that is. It's just adding another usability factor to your site. And a lot of them are really cool. What a lot of them are able to do. It's amazing what some of these guys come out with that work with sites.
Since we're on the subject here, I'm just going to do a quick plug at Sell Term Life. We actually build WordPress sites for agents. So just check that out there if you're interested in building a website. Yeah.
So, and do they go to, would it be selltermlife.com? Is that information there?
Yeah, selltermlife.com. Just click on the website tab at top, and there's a few different options there.
That's interesting. Awesome. Yeah, I'm sure you'll get some calls. Getting back to talking about some of the different products that you've been able to market online, obviously Term. And can you give us kind of what the, because I know you sell final expense all the time in your agency as well. Can you give us kind of an overview of what, you know, because a lot of guys out there, they're hard-headed, you know, they're like, well, no, you can't sell final expense from a lead, you know, from an internet-generated lead. Or, like you said, now, if you're going through a vendor or something like that, I think there's going to be diminishing returns at some point just because of the way they're doing it. But like you said, if you do it yourself, can you give a little, was that a surprise to you at all when that started happening?
When what started happening?
When the final expense, when you started like generating some of the leads through yourself, they started converting to that?
I mean, not really. I mean, it's always been there. It's been there for the past few years, and, you know, it's just more and more, you know, and a lot of people are searching for it online. A lot of the websites our agents have that are ranking for final expense, burial insurance, funeral insurance, those types of keywords, and, you know, even longer tail keywords. I mean, I know agents getting 50 plus leads per day from just one post about final expense.
Right.
People are searching online. Wow. I mean, it's one of the highest search terms, but, you know, it's being searched, and that's telling in itself. So, and I mean, I love selling final expense over the phone, by the way. I mean, it's easy to explain. It's, you know, it's easy to apply for. It's no exam. You get paid quicker. I mean, I would love to sell final expense over the phone. And yeah, I mean, a lot of people are talking about the persistency is low. But if you have people searching you out, you know, and they for final expense, I mean, you're not selling a final expense policy to somebody who may need it, but they may not, you know. These people actually want the coverage, and our persistency is really good on organic traffic. I mean, these people keep.
I have heard that. Yeah. People that sell a final expense to the internet leads, they do stick a lot more. Their persistency is way higher. Yeah.
If you're buying leads, you know, for example, it may not, you know, it may not translate the same way, but for the people who are actually seeking out final expense policy and request quotes, these people actually want it. And the persistency, I believe, is the same as a face-to-face agent. It's if you're shoving a final expense policy down somebody who may or may not believe in, you know, in the concept. So that's where you see the persistency going down for those. I mean, if you're a call center robot.
Or may not actually understand exactly what they're responding to sometimes, you know.
Right.
You know, that happens a lot with face-to-face, and you have to, you know, kind of explain why you're there, which is fine. You can work through all that. But it's, like you said, this is something that it's kind of in the, well, I guess to some of us, maybe it's not in the infancy stage, but overall, I think it is. You know, like you said, next 10 years at least, it's going to really start to have a compounding effect on mail. Response rates are going down, and not just for final expense. I would assume, and from what I've heard, the same thing with the Medicare market, and annuity, all that. The mail is going down, and I can absolutely see it on annuity driven type agencies and products. It's going to go down. It's probably never really been that strong anyway. But so what advice, Jeff? We've been on here a little while. I know you got a lot to take care of today. I don't want to hold it too long. What advice could you give to somebody that is listening to this and they're like, you know, whether they're a final expense guy doing face-to-face or they're somebody that's brand new to the industry and they're not sure which way they want to go, just your gut feeling from your experience, what you've been able to do and kind of how you forecasted what you see coming in the future, what would you tell a new guy coming in? What's one of the first couple of things they need to do to set themselves up for success going forward if they want to be part of the what I call the online revolution?
Yeah, I think the main thing is your mindset needs to shift to become that you're more of a marketer than you are a salesperson. If you want to be in the internet space, the online space, you need to become a marketer. You need to educate yourself. You need to commit to that. I think that's the agents that are getting the most traction are the ones who commit to that. So they'll keep doing what they're doing. They'll keep doing the direct mail. They'll keep doing, you know, whatever referral relationship they have. Whatever's bringing them an income, they're doing that. But at the same time, they're carving out a couple hours a day educating themselves, implementing, writing content, learning, taking a paid traffic course, you know, setting a small budget of $5, $10 a day and seeing how it does over time and you know, optimize that. But do something. I mean, if you want to get into the space, don't jump right in, you know, kind of put your toes in, figure a few things out, keep doing what you're currently doing and just carve out a couple hours a day, even an hour a day to make it work. You know, with technology, it's never been easier to communicate and build a business in any industry. And, you know, I've even toyed with, selling other physical products because of my expertise in marketing and everything. And I've never seen a better product to sell online. I mean, where else can you get 100% plus margins and not carry inventory, you know? I mean,
exactly.
If you think about
exactly.
It, you know? So there's no reason for me to go anywhere else. This is really, it's a great place to be once you get there. The hardest part is getting there, taking that, you know, educating yourself, getting that information. But you don't need to do it all today and just say, hey, I'm going to sell online and over the phone. You know, take small baby steps and get there. That's what most agents do. A lot of the most successful agents that I've, you know, trained and work with, they've all, you know, I've pulled them from a New York life insurance agency or Mass Mutual or some captive shop where they were doing what they're currently doing. And at the same time, you know, on the side, and this is probably, you know, they probably weren't supposed to be doing this, but they started working on their websites. And as soon as they got a few leads, they left. And that's kind of how they went through it. And I'm always recommending to agents, keep doing what you're currently doing to bring in an income, because while this does take a while to grow, it snowballs and it keeps growing. So, you know, agents that started a few years ago, you know, I have an agent that came to me 2.5 years ago. He was from New York Life. You know, he followed kind of the processes we put in this book. And during that time, he figured out a lot of things, specifically his higher dollar keywords, where he was getting business from, where he liked to work. And then he started targeting those people. And, you know, he went from zero website 2.5, 3 years ago to now he's generating over 1,100 leads a month because he focused on internet marketing. He spent hours and hours a day on his website. But that's where he is now, and he never probably has to sell a policy again because now he has other agents selling for him. So the cool thing about the internet business is you can really scale this to beyond just your capacity because you can create those processes and everything. But to get back to, you know, somebody kind of deciding what to do is, you know, you're a marketer. You have to educate yourself. That's where it starts. Don't just jump in right away. You have to learn as you go. Keep doing what you're currently doing.
Awesome. Yeah, and guys need to remember, too, that guy that's generating all those leads, he can't sell them all, so there's an agency for you.
Exactly. No, he has an agency now,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Got to put the lead somewhere. Can't let them go to waste.
Right.
So I'm looking here. Let's see. Last year, you generated over 20,000 life insurance inquiries online. Wow. Mm-hmm. So for everybody listening, you need to go to SaleTermLife.com. Again, that's SaleTermLife.com. You also, Jeff, what's the best way they could purchase your book? Through Amazon, and maybe go ahead and give them
Right. On selltermlife.com on the homepage, there's a link to my book there. So you can just go there.
Okay.
Or if you just go to Amazon.com and do a search for digital life insurance agent, that's okay. The name of the book. It'll pop up there.
Okay. Excellent. Great stuff. Great time here with you. Look, I appreciate your time and your willingness to put stuff like this out there that helps the industry. I think more of that is needed because there's not enough of it out there. A lot of agents tend to be stingy with their knowledge and content. So I hope everybody realizes $15 is not a lot to spend on the value of this book. And I'm going to pick up a lot of nuggets from it as well. So I really appreciate your time, Jeff. And again, guys, you want to go to selltermlife.com for more information, and then look for the link there to the Amazon to purchase the book, or go to Amazon directly to purchase and get a hold of this. And look over some of the other services he offers. Obviously, like you said before, Jeff, you guys do help agents build out websites and stuff like that, correct?
That's correct. Yep.
Okay. All righty. Well, I guess that's about it. We covered a ton of stuff. Again, I appreciate you being here, Jeff. And is there anything else you'd like to add?
No. I mean, we covered a lot here. Everything that we discussed here is discussed in the book as well. So
there you go.
It's all out there. It's all laid out.
Okay. All righty. I appreciate it, Jeff. And I'll go take care of them two babies.
All right. Appreciate you, Matt. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Bye-bye.
Bye.
All righty, guys. There you go. Another interview for you. I want to thank Jeff Root for his time. And also, make sure you guys go and search Amazon or Google it. The Digital Life Insurance Agent, How to Market Life Insurance Online and Sell Over the Phone. Jeff did not hold back in the information he provided in this book, and it's well worth the price tag. So go and get it. As always, for the best final expense leads in the country, visit www.theleadjerk.com. Again, www.theleadjerk.com. Thanks, guys.